Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Students, in this video, we'll discuss about the relationship between the linear velocity and angular velocity. So let us start with the relation. Students, let us start with the relationship between the linear velocity and its angular counterpart. The linear velocity and angular velocity. We have V stands for linear velocity and omega stands for angular velocity. First of all, we'll derive this in scalar form, then we'll discuss about its vector form. Suppose that I have a circle like so, and the object is moving in anti-clockwise sense from here to here, from position A to position B. This point is O. Now, as it moves from A to B, I say that it takes time delta t, and the angle traced here is the displacement here is delta theta. This length, arc length, is suppose delta s is the distance, it is not the displacement. Delta s stands for the distance, and that is the actual path described by the particle along this line. This is basically the arc length. Now, supposing that the particle is moving in anti-clockwise sense, we are interested in linear velocity and angular velocity relation. The linear velocity is, first of all, we'll define the linear velocity at a point, instantaneous linear velocity. The velocity average can be found, average linear velocity, throughout this total distance covered. The average velocity is delta s over delta t. This is our average velocity. This is your average velocity. Rather, I will say the average speed. The average speed is delta s over delta t. This is the average speed. Moving from point A to point B, this is the average speed. That means this is the distance covered in this much time. I suppose this distance to be large and this time supposed to be very long. Now, if I want to write this, I want to find the average. I cannot say that this is the velocity at A or this is the velocity at B, because the velocity will be always tangent to the curve. So here the velocity direction is this one, here the velocity direction is this one. Now, the average velocity, or if I want the velocity, average velocity, it will be somewhere else in the direction. At A is like so, at B like so, then what about the average velocity direction. It is from A to B, direct line joining, and it is something like that. Now I'm interested in the velocity at any point, say at an instant, say A, then I have to bring this point very close to A. For that I have to reduce the time. That means in short, I have to take the limiting value of this value. So if I take the limiting value, I write V instantaneous. Then this is the linear velocity, and that is the limiting value of delta t tends to 0 delta s over delta t. So this is the velocity at point A, so velocity at this point A. Now the velocity at point A, at any point A or B it can say, is limit delta t tends to 0 delta s over delta t. Now limit delta t tends to 0 delta s can be represented, because this is in linear form. I want angular velocity, so I know the relation that angle described is arc length upon the radius of the circle, which is r. Now so delta s can be represented as r delta theta, so this is r delta theta over delta t. This can be written like that. The arc length, because this is the arc length, so this represents the speed part. R is a constant in a circular motion, so it is taken outside. Limiting value delta t tends to 0 delta theta over delta t. This is your nothing but omega. So this implies that V we are getting is R, and this part is omega by definition. By definition, the omega is limit delta t tends to 0 delta theta over delta t. This is the instantaneous omega, omega at that particular instant. So this is also instantaneous, this is instantaneous, and this is also instantaneous. That means in general velocity at any point V equals to omega r. This is the relationship we are getting here. The linear velocity is angular velocity into the radius of the circle. Now in terms of vector, I will have to find a way that in vector form it is the cross product of, you can see that the velocity at suppose this point is here. This is the direction of velocity, and this is the direction of r. This is the center, and this is the axis of rotation. This is your direction of omega. If it is anticlockwise, then you should satisfy the condition that r cross omega, or omega cross r, if it is moving like that, omega is here, is r v. This is omega cross r. Because if this is in anticlockwise sense, omega is this direction. Suppose this is your r vector, and the velocity at this point will be obviously in this direction, perpendicular to r, then omega cross r is v. But if I take r cross omega, it is not v. So this is the correct relation. If I solve this, then I'll get a magnitude part of this, or I write this one v equals to omega r sine theta. this R vector and this V vector makes an angle of 90 degree. So therefore, this is omega R is the linear relationship, and vector wise this is the formula. So that is all about your relations V and omega. Thank you.